How can I not?
This?
We already get started momentarily. I'm just going to ask that you guys go ahead and please mute your end of the video. So take this moment and mute
your video. You need your bullhorn. You're hard to hear.
You can't hear me?
Oh, I think you have to put on mute.
Is that what you're saying? Put it on mute?
Yes.
Yeah, put it on mute.
Well, I can hear a lot of people. We got to put that on mute so that we can all hear me a little bit better.
It's
not working.
Hey Leah, I think you can mute everybody through Zoom.
Yeah,
I think on your Zoom app you can mute everybody.
Awesome, thank you.
Yeah.
All right, guys. I'm Leah. This is Erin. We're gonna go ahead and have a fun workout today. The things you're gonna need for this workout, you're gonna need to grab a pen and a piece of paper. We're gonna be writing a couple things down today. And then you're also gonna need an object that you can lift up and put down. So we have plates here. A plate's gonna help you just have a target to jump on. We're gonna be doing some jumping in and out today. So if you wanna have a plate, you can do that. Or you can literally grab any object. It won't move on you. Don't grab a cat, don't grab a kid today. Yesterday you could, today that won't work. You do need something, maybe like a weight. You could use a kettlebell. You could use a sandbag. Get creative. We're gonna give you guys 2 minutes to acquire these things, go to the bathroom, grab some water, and then we'll get started in about 1 to 2 minutes.
Yeah, I wish that wasn't reversed.
I know.
Is there a setting where it doesn't reverse it? It's like direct view instead of mirror
just
view?
Look.
I don't know. We can tinker around with it. I don't want to like mess it up right now.
All right, guys. So we're going to get started. Today we have a lactic tolerance workout. What that means is that the work that we're going to do is push your intensity. It's going to make your legs feel really jello-y, and it's going to make us feel like we have to stop going or moving at the same speed that we were originally moving in our first round. Your goal is to maintain consistency, speed, and reps across the time frame that we are given. We posted the workout in our Facebook members group. Unfortunately, it's reversed on our frame here, so I'll do my best to explain this right now. On your piece of paper, you're going to write the following. Number one, skaters. Skaters are going to be side-to-side movement. I'll have Erin demonstrate these. Using power and getting as high as possible. The low impact is going to be a slow version where you're stepping side-to-side. Number two, for the exercise, we have plank hands. For your plank hands, if you have a plate, you're going to be down on the ground. We're going to come up on our plate and come down. Up and down. If you don't have a plate, you'll do plank tap. Here. Our number three movement is going to be a ground to an overhead press. We're going to go ahead, straddle our plate, and pick it up so that the tip or the lip of the plate is touching the floor. From here, we're going to bring it to our chest, press up, come down, and squat down. Up and down. If you don't have an object, we can do squat jumps here. The next movement is going to be a plank jump. From our plank position, we're going to be jumping our feet in and out, in and out. going to be a slow mountain climber. You can't put weight on your arm, you'll be doing bicycle crunches. Here. Last movement that we're going to be doing is a plank jump. In, out, in, out, in, out, in, out. Or you'll be on the ground, in, out, in, out. We're going to go ahead and get warmed up. Those are the main movements that you're going to see today. For a warm-up, we're going to start with 10 squats. Down and up. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. From here, we're going to go into a four-point squat. Fold over. Legs are straight here. We're going to grab our toes, pull our butt down. Arms come up overhead and stand. Four more. Bend, pull the butt down, arms come up, stand. Two. These are hard. Three. Oh gosh. Four. Five. After that, guys, we are going to get a squat to a hop. Squat to a hop, nice and slow. Five, four, three, two, one. We're gonna speed it up now. Five, four, three, two, one. Everybody go ahead into a Spider-Man stretch. We're gonna step back, knee is at a 90 degree angle. I'm gonna plant my opposite hand and rotate up and switch. I'm gonna do this three times on each side. Good. Last time on each side. Excellent. From here, we're going into our plank pass-throughs. Hands are coming up into the high plank position. Drive your chest down and come forward. One more time. Three. Two. One. From here, we're on all fours. Hands gonna come behind the head. We're gonna touch the seam of our opposite elbow and then rotate up. Five times on each side. Four. Three. Two. One, switch sides. Elbow to the sky and then pull it down. Two. Three. Four. Five. Awesome. All right, guys. We're transitioning to the learning part of our workout where we're going to slowly incorporate the movements we'll see in the MetCon today into our warm-up. First movement we're going to do is skaters. We're just going to do a couple of reps here. For the skater, you're going to be jumping to the side and then back again. The more power we use, the harder this will be, the more impact it will be. So if you have any injuries going on, we'll get low and we'll do a side step for speed. Here we go, guys. Let's go ahead and get 10 reps. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That is your skater. Exercise number two, plank hand. So we're gonna be on our plate. We're going to be coming up onto our plank and down, or we're going to just plank and get our hands to our shoulders. We're going to go ahead. Here we go. 10 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Excellent, guys. Our ground to overhead press. Or squat jump, you get to decide what works best for you. I'm gonna be doing the ground overhead. Aaron will do squat jump. We're gonna get five. Go ahead. One, two, three, four, five. Awesome, guys. See some plates over there. You guys look great. Love it.
Woo!
After that, guys, we have our plank jumps. We're planking from this position. We're either going to get a slow march or we're hopping our feet in and out. Let's go ahead and get five. Go. One, two, three, four, five. Excellent. Our last movement is going to be the plank jump. From here, in, up, in, out. Go ahead and give me 20. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Faster. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Grab some water, guys. That's our warm up. Take a minute break here.
Let's check in, make sure everyone's.
All right, guys, we're going to check in just to see how you guys are doing.
See my mom. How do I?
Hey everybody, how we doing? Hey Colin, how's it going? We getting warm out there?
Yeah, Via.
Yeah, there we go, Via. Guys. Awesome. Okay. All right, guys.
So those are the movements that we're gonna see. What we're gonna do now is a little drill that's gonna determine your personal reps for the EMOM that we'll do in just a few minutes. How this is gonna work? We're gonna do each of those movements in the same order that we just did them, but this time we're doing them for 10 seconds. You're gonna count the amount of times you can do each movement in 10 seconds. You're gonna write that number down. Skaters, 10 seconds. If I get 20, I'll write 20 skaters on my piece of paper. Eventually, we're gonna use these numbers. That's gonna be your personal EMOM. Super good, because we can all be doing the same workout at a pace that is right for us. Go ahead, guys. Get ready. Get your piece of paper nearby. We're going to be starting with skaters. I'll have a timer here, and I'll also direct you. The first movement we're doing, skaters. Get ready. 10 seconds. Till we get going, guys. Here we go, guys. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Fast as you can go. Go, go, go. Go faster. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Rest. We have 20 seconds of rest before we do 10 seconds. Like this. Write down that number, guys. Here we go. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go. Fast as you can go. Go, go, go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and done. Woo! All right, guys, we're moving on. Round overhead press. We have about 12 more seconds of rest here. Remember, you're writing down each number after you finish it. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Keep going, guys. And rest. Good. Like the jumping our feet in and out where we have that mountain climber mark. 10 seconds. Remember, we're going as fast as we can physically go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Keep going, guys. Keep going. Keep going. And rest. Woo! My heart rate's already up. We're just getting started, guys. After that, we have plate hops or the in and out hops. You get to choose. Here we go, guys. 5 seconds. In 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Faster, guys, faster, go, 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 go. You gotta move, let's go. 3, 2, 1, and rest. All right, guys. What we just did is create our own personal EMOM. I want you to take a look at your list. We're gonna pretend, we're gonna go through one as an example for Aaron.
Erin, let's say, how many skaters did you get?
18.
18 skaters.
Total, like so.
Yeah, 18 total skaters, okay? Like, stand. About 24, maybe?
Yeah.
Yeah.
24.
24. Ground to overhead press. Erin got?
Nine. Or maybe six. Sorry.
That's okay, six. Up. Okay, yeah.
Six.
Plank jumps. Erin got?
Nine
plank jumps. And for plate hop, she got?
14.
So, Erin just created her own personal EMOM. So, what you're going to do, every minute on the minute for the next 6 minutes, you're going to complete the same exact reps in a row. Okay? So, 1 minute, we're completing every single one of those movements we just determined. This is going to get hard. You're going to want to slow down. If you slow down, you won't make the time cutoff. If you find that your endurance is starting to fall, we can always scale those numbers as needed. Does that make sense, guys? Everybody give me a thumbs up. Yeah. All right, we're going to crush this, guys. Let me set up the timer. Grab some water. Take a second. Make sure that you have everything you need.
So 18, 24.
Okay, so we're going to be doing 6 minutes. 6 minutes here, guys. We're going to be on for 1 minute. There's Brian, guys. Say hi to Brian. And we're going to get zero rest. You're going to be working as fast as possible. You guys ready to go?
Woo!
Woo! All right, guys. We're going to jump around. That's right. Here we go. 10 seconds, and we're going. Here we go. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. We're doing this all over again. Get ready in 3, 2, 1, and go. Better, Erin?
Yeah.
Nice job, guys. Here we go. You're completing each number every single minute. Let's go. You got it. Here we go, Erin.
Nice job, guys.
Awesome. I'm loving what I'm seeing, guys. I'm seeing everybody working so hard. Let's go. You got this. Keep going. You got 20 seconds left. You got to move, guys. You got to move. Nice job, guys. Keep working. You got this. All right, guys, round number 3. We're getting started in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Go, guys, you got this. Woo! Round number 4, guys. she be a burn. We gotta fight to get these. Here we go. And go. Here we go, guys. Nice job, Karen, looking good. Nice job, Kathy. Here you go, Nikhil. Get some, let's go, guys.
Nice job, Erin. Erin's keeping a nice consistent pace, guys, she looks great. Here we go, Erin. 30 seconds left. Good job, Erin. Way to hustle. Nice job. Here we go, guys. Hang in there. 15 more seconds. Faster. You got it. 10 seconds. Woo! All right, guys. Last round. We're going to do it together, and then we'll get the core work in. Here we go. In 3, 2, 1, go. Here we go, guys. Keep moving. Core work, okay? Go ahead, grab some water. We're gonna meet back here in 1 minute, guys. Grab some water. Woo! How we feeling, guys? Feeling good? Thumbs up if we're feeling good, guys. Awesome. Woo-woo! All right, guys, bring it on in. We're gonna go ahead and get started with some core. What we're gonna be doing is timed four intervals. We'll do 20 seconds on, 20 seconds off, and you'll follow along on the TV. Okay, here we go. Let me grab this timer here. We're gonna be doing 6 rounds again, but they're gonna look a little bit different this time. Because we're only going 20 seconds. Then we get 20 seconds of rest. The 1-to-1 work to rest ratio we got going on. We're gonna get started, guys. We're just gonna get started with an ab mat sit up, or we can do a crunch. You get to choose ab mat sit up or a crunch. We're going in 10 seconds. Here we go, guys. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. So we can do just a crunch here. Or we can do an ab mat sit up, which Erin is doing. You can decide. Five, four, two, one. Nice. We're going to be doing glute bridges next. Feet are stacked underneath the knees, hands are down. We're going to squeeze our butt and raise, but we've still got about 12 seconds, guys, before we do this. You can add a weight to your hips if you want an additional challenge. We're going to get started here in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. And rest. We're flipping over with that Superman, guys. We're going to keep our chins upside down. And we've got about 10 seconds before we go, but we're going to keep our head down, raise everything up, and put everything down. Excellent. Here we go, guys, in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and go. Guys, look great. Keep it up. Keep that head down. 3, 2, 1. We're back to the beginning, guys. We're going to ab mat sit up or crunches. You get to decide. Mom, I'm so proud of you. Figuring out technology. Here we go, guys. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! Marky Mark, gotta love him. 10 seconds, guys. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. We're going back to those glute bridges. You know what that means. We're going to work hard. How are we doing, guys? You know what I would love? I would really love to see everyone put their camera view on so we can light up the screen and do this one together, because we're going to need to be in this one together. It's going to get a little hard. So everyone, I want to see everyone's faces right now. If your camera is not on camera view, let's go. There we go. There we go. There we go. Yes. Yes. Hey, Kathy. Hey, Nate. What's up? Yeah. There we go, guys.
Yeah.
Yes. Light it up, Wendy.
Love
it. Yes. Hi, Colin.
Oh, I love it.
Hey, Karen. Hey. All right, you guys. Hey, Marissa. Awesome. Okay, guys, so we're going to go ahead and get started. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to do as many squats as possible in 1 minute. Cool? You're going to count this number 2 and write it down, because in 2 weeks we're going to retest this. So
1 minute of squats. Erin's going to demo a squat right now for us.
I'm not the best at squats.
Down and up. We got to get full extension through that hip. Okay, we're going to do as many as possible in a minute, and I want to see you move, okay?
Let me get this timer up. All right, guys. 10 seconds. We're going for a full minute. As many as possible. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go. Nice job, guys. You'll notice our clock's still going in the background. That's because we have 45 more seconds before we repeat this and try to beat our first score. Woo-hoo! Yeah, we're going to have some fun. It's going to burn. I'm going to encourage all you guys to take a selfie or to have someone in your family take a photo of you getting this burn challenge in, guys. We're going to tag our friends who didn't do it with us today, and we're going to have them do it later. Erin's got a sweet moonwalk right there. Anyone else able to moonwalk? All right, guys, we've got about 15 seconds and we're doing this again. As many squats as possible in one full minute. It's going to burn. You got to just mind over matter it, guys. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
Nice job, Karen. Nice job, Sandra. Yeah, Clancy family. Look at you guys popping up now. That's awesome. Get it. Nice job, Amy. Here we go, Nikki. Yeah, Marissa. Get some, Nate. Get some. Nice job, John and family. Here we go, Bill and Kim. Good. Raise a hand if your legs are feeling jello. Yeah. Good work, guys. Good work. Nice. Hey, Nikhil. What's up? I see you. Hey, Claudette.
Hey, guys.
Nice job, you guys. I'm so impressed by everyone right now.
Oh, my goodness.
Ooh, I love the song.
Oh, good.
All right, guys, so we're not done yet. Now that we know that little routine, that little game we just played, we're going to do it again, but with push-ups.
Oh, no.
Oh.
Oh, no. I know. I'm seeing people's faces go, oh, no. A minute of push-ups, But this time we're going to pace ourselves. Our legs tend to be a little stronger than our upper body. We have a little more endurance, so we're able to push that a little bit more. Our arms, not so much. You're going to get to the point where you're going to feel like your arms are going to fall off if we go out too hard or too soon. So what we need to do is pace ourselves. Our push-up options for the day. We have on our knees. Keeping your back nice and straight, she's going to come all the way down. Her arms are at a 45-degree angle. We have hand release push-ups, where she's going to come up full plank position and come all the way down. And then we've got the full push-up, if you dare, guys, all the way down, all the way up. If you can only do maybe 5 to 10 full push-ups, they recommend scaling down. Whatever you normally do for a short rep range, we'll scale down a modification. I want to see everyone's cameras here. We're going to need this accountability, guys. Set those things up. Go, guys. Woo-hoo. All right, guys. Push-up time. Push-up time. Here we go. 10 seconds. Oops. Wait, sorry, my bad. Oops, 10 seconds. 10 seconds for real this time. Here we go. Woo! Get that music up for you. Here we go, guys. In 3, 2, 1.
Hit it.
Keep going, guys. You got this. Nice job, everybody. Halfway. Halfway, guys. Feeling, guys.
Ooh, that was really hard.
We've got 45 seconds, guys. Dance party.
Nobody wants to dance. They're like, no big.
Yeah, Karen. Woo! Yeah, Amy. Get ready. Here we go. In 3, 2, 1. Mobility now. Grab some water. We'll meet back in 1 minute. Grab some water, guys. Wipe your sweat off. Do whatever you need to do. Grab a mat if you need to protect your knee. If you have sensitive knees on the floor, you can do that right now. You can double up the floor with a towel, whatever you need to do. Oh, look at that baby.
Oh, my God.
Hey, guys. Thanks for joining us.
Oh, my God. It's so awesome. Oh, there's Mia. Oh, I love it.
Oh, Mia, look at those dance moves.
Ooh, Mia. Mia. Hi, Mia.
Oh, my God. This is awesome. Oh, look at the Clancy clip. Oh, my God. This is awesome.
Hey, Colin. We just see your fingertips,
hey,
but I see you.
Woo!
You guys are crushing it. Even though we can't really be at the facility, we can still all be together and do workouts, so that's super cool. Nikhil, I like your elephant painting.
Oh, that's pretty
yeah,
sweet.
Cool. Claudette. All right, guys, we're going to go ahead and get started with our mobility.
Hey, guys, so what we're going to do, we're going to start in the child's pose position. Our knees are going to be a little bit wider than hips width apart, and our toes are going to be together. We're going to roll forward and reach our hands out as far as possible while keeping our chin tucked in a healthy position. And we're just going to breathe here for a few seconds. Nice deep breath in through the nose and exhale out. Start to calm our heart rate down a little bit, start to even our breathing out. On the next deep breath in, we're going to take a seat back into our feet, and we're going to walk both of our hands all the way to the left, pushing our hips down and to the right. Walk it back to center and through to the other side. All right, guys, we're now going to take our right leg. We're going to put it forward 90 degrees in this front knee here. We're going to slide our back leg back. And we're going to go ahead and put our hands on our front knee. Chest up and breathe. So earlier, guys, I posted some daily challenges for you guys to try to hit today. One of them was to put on Marky Mark's Good Vibrations and have a dance party. So if you haven't done that yet, do it. It's going to bring a smile to your face. It's going to get you guys moving. The second one is going to be to write down your gratitude list. Keeping a positive outlook helps in times of stress, and it can also help us to feel more resilient. The third one is going to be from Coach John and I for nutrition, and that's to drink half your body weight in water today. Okay, ooh. So definitely keep us updated on the members post that I did earlier this morning. Let us know what you're doing. Take photos, tag people that you want to do this challenge with you, and we'll all be healthier for it. Good, go ahead and switch sides.
Ooh, that's good. It's a hard workout today, huh?
Oh my gosh.
So that workout, guys, was inspired by Aerobic Capacity, which is a CrossFit affiliate endurance program run by Chris Hinshaw. So if you like that, you can tag Aerobic Capacity in your post today. Good, guys. After that, we're going to be going down into a plank pass-through. Hey, guys, say hi to Mike.
Mike, you want to join us for some mobility or stretching?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, guys, we're going to go into a plank pass-through. Onto our high plank, we're going to drive our chest down towards our quads, pushing our hands as far as we can into the floor to create tension through the arm, and then we're coming back to the high plank. We're going to get about four more.
Four.
Three. Two. And one. After that, guys, we're going to be on our backs. Well, excited so you can see my form here. We're going to be grounding our lower back into the floor. We're going to put one leg up into the sky. The other leg is going to make a figure four on top here. Okay, we're going into our figure four stretch for that piriformis here. We're going to put our hands through this little window we've created, grab our hamstring, and then pull towards us. The closer your heel is to your hip crease, the more you're going to feel this in your inner thigh and your piriformis muscle. So these muscles get super tight from sitting a lot, which I know a lot of us are doing a lot more of now. So you can do this one daily to help keep you mobile.
Oh, I love this song.
Oh, yeah.
All
right, guys, go ahead and switch legs.
Everybody.
All right, guys. After that, we're going to put our hands out in the shape of a T, and we're going to be dropping both knees to one side. If you tend to be a flexible person, we can actually cross our legs. That's going to anchor our muscle down a little bit more. So I'm going to drop both my knees to the left, so my right knee is going to be on top if we're taking that option. We're going to take a nice deep breath in, and as we exhale, we're going to let our knees drop. We're going to look over that opposite shoulder. Our tendency here will be to take shallow breaths, try to fight that, and try to expand your belly as much as possible with air. All right, guys. Legs back to the center, and we're going to switch it out. So my legs are dropping to the right. My left leg will come on top. Trying to get my knees to the floor, keeping both arms in contact with the ground, looking over that opposite shoulder. All right, guys, knees back to the center. We're going to plant both of our feet on the ground. And we're going to get our core and our glutes just a little bit to help us stretch out. So our hands are going to be planted. We're going to go into that glute bridge. And then we're going to draw both of our knees into our chest. Flex our feet and tap, tap our heels. And grab. So we're going to do a hip bridge. Come up. Tap, tap. And down. Three more times. Glute bridge. Knees come up. Tap, tap, and down. All right, guys, after your last one, go ahead and come to the seated position. Our last one is going to be for our neck muscles, which get tight when we sit a lot as well. I know a lot of us are working at home, and it's probably tempting to sit on the couch with our laptop. Ergonomically, that's not very good for our posture, and it's going to lead to a lot of tension through our neck and our shoulders. So it's a really great idea to stack some books up and at least have that posture at the right height. You can look at online for those heights and measurements. We're going to take our ear on the opposite side. My ear is going to come down, kiss my right shoulder, and I'm going to slightly draw my head away from that extended arm.
Are you okay?
Yeah. All right, guys. It was awesome to see everybody. You guys all on video. So if everyone could come back on screen, let's see the big workout photo. Yeah, guys. Let me see all those. Hey, Marissa.
Hi.
Hi, guys.
Sandy. All right, guys, this is awesome. You guys look great. Let's all flex. Let's give some muscles or some thumbs up. Yeah, there we go.
Can you show your muscles, Tom?
Yeah, love it. All right, guys, you have an awesome day, and we're going to release the new workout schedule.
Tomorrow, we're going to have our first live class at 7 a.m. So that's going to be a mobility session with me. So you guys have been working your butts off all week, doing a lot of home workouts, a lot of burpees, probably a lot of air squats. So we're going to focus on some mobility at 7. We'll have another Thrive class at 9 and 12. And then we're going to have a CrossFit workout at 5:30 p.m. Those are all going to be through Zoom. So we'll get all those links out as well. And our goal is to build out and add more classes. We're just trying to get our feet wet with the whole virtual model of things. So you want to ask?
Do you want me to? Do you guys think, could everyone hear Leah, like, okay? I just want to make sure, like, the experience was good.
Yeah, it was great. Like, this was awesome.
Yeah, this was cool.
Thank you, guys.
Louder the closer you are.
Okay, so maybe I'll come over to the screen a little more.
Yeah, see, that's...
But it was good.
Awesome.
Yeah, it was awesome.
Thank you so much. It was so
fun. Thank you.
Morning.
Thank you guys. It was great to see you. Nice.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you.
Good night, everyone.
See you guys.
Bye.
Bye. Thank you.